Drop area is one of the interaction objects in Active Presenter 8. This object is useful in creating drag and drop interactions. Here, there is only one drop area. When each drag source is dropped in, a feedback message will show up immediately. As you can see, the drop area is different from the drag and drop question. A drag and drop question has more than one drop target, and the feedback layer won't show up until you complete dragging all drag sources into drop targets. Now, let's learn how to work with a drop area object. First of all, to insert a drop area, open the Insert tab. Select Drop Area. Draw it wherever you want on the canvas. By default, a drop area object includes a drop area, a drag source, a drag and drop connector, a correct message, and an incorrect message. Click the drop area to add text. Select the drag source. Access the Style and Effects tab at the Properties pane. Notice the Fill section. Select Image Fill. Then choose an image from your file system. Drag the drag source to your desired position. You can convert any objects to drag sources. Select multiple objects. Open the Interactivity tab at the Properties pane. Notice the Drag and Drop section. Select Drag Source. Optionally, you can add an effect for drag sources. For example, I select Zoom. The drag source will be zoomed in when you drag it. In order to set more than one correct answer, just click the drag source to show this marker. Then drag it into the drop area. On the other hand, you can select the drop area, then edit the Accept List dialog as mentioned in How to Create Drag and Drop Questions video. For the drop area, I select Zoom Effect 2. Active Presenter allows you to edit properties of drag sources after you drop them into a drop area. For example, I want to resize drag sources into smaller ones. And they will be at the center of the drop area. A drop area object can not only validate learners' actions but also give them points for correct actions. To set points for correct actions, see How to Create Drag and Drop Questions video for details. Apart from the default feedback messages, you can add more if necessary. Select the drop area, open the Questions tab. Select Message. Here, I choose a timeout message for example. At the Interactivity tab, tick the timeout checkbox and change its duration to reach your needs. Active Presenter automatically offers default events, actions for the drop area. You can add more depending on your needs. That's it. Thanks for watching.